What's up, drillers? This is Dylan Ruskin, the creator or founder of Brain Drill. How's everybody doing? Hopefully good. So basically I was going to make this video that I like to call the Chronicles of Brain Drill, which is basically just like a history. You know, I mean, we've been a band for 10 years now, so since 2006, so 10 years roughly, maybe a little bit longer than that. And so I was basically just going to do a history of the beginning of Brain Drill till present, and just a history of all the albums that we've released in the last 10 years. And so I'd like to start with this one, which is actually just a demo that we released in 2006. And I was definitely stoked on it. This album has 6 songs on it. It was recorded at Castle Ultimate Studios by Zach Oren. And it's basically just the three of us. It's me, Steve, and Marco on it. We didn't have a bass player yet, so I just recorded all the bass tracks myself. So this was basically meant to just be released as a demo, and it kind of just ended up leaking onto eBay and started getting sold through there. But the first song that I'm going to play is The Parasites, because that was pretty much what started it all. You know, the first song that I gave to Marco on a click track was The Parasites, and he sent me this video of him jamming to that song. And the second I saw it, or saw what he was playing, I was just like, holy shit, like, he just like hit the nail on the head. He just hit the, you know, hit the ball out of the park or whatever, so to speak, because it was like exactly what I wanted to have drums sound like, you know, to the music that I was writing. So I was super stoked on it. And one cool thing about this CD is that if you were one of the lucky ones that had this demo, have this demo, it's this really cool like luminescent thing that I've only seen like one other band that has this, and it's Agoraphobic Nosebleed, I think, was the only band that really did this. And I'm sure there's others, but that's the only band I know of. And they've got Agoraphobic Nosebleed, is basically the CD is just this, but I just kind of like how the guy made it, and it's just got this cool luminescent thing around the CD, and it still plays like a normal CD. So I'm going to go ahead and play The Parasites. Yeah. Sweet. Yeah. So that was that demo. That was in 2006 released. So the next one that I'm going to talk about is our 2008 release. Hopefully I'll have enough time to talk about everything. So the next one was this one, Apocalyptic Feasting, which came out in 2008. This is after we got signed to Metal Blade Records. This was our first release from Metal Blade Records. Super stoked on the fact that, you know, it has a quote right from Alex Webster himself on the front. It says, "Brain Driller, one of the most musically over-the-top bands I've ever heard. They're truly raising the bar for technicality, velocity, and overall extremity in death metal." So super stoked on that. He basically was the reason why we got signed to Metal Blade. And so before we signed, we actually joined in Jeff Huggle at the time, who's now bass player of 6 Feet Under. He plays the 7-string, is real shreddy. So he definitely brought a lot of good stuff to the album, especially on the last song on the album, which is Sadistic Abductive. He does a really cool bass solo on it. And then also on Bury the Living, which is a song that he wrote himself, and I kind of just turned it into like a guitar version. There's cool bass solos on that as well. So that's from 2008. Some of the songs from the demo are also on this one, because I figured I would just throw in 4 songs and it would just be the full length at that point. But so this is Apocalyptic Feasting. I'm going to play that track right now. The title track. We'll be right back. Cool. So that was Apocalyptic Feasting. So that was that album. So that spanned from, you know, the original members were from 2006 to about 2008. Then we had a lineup change, and we switched over to 2010, which was our release, Quantum Catastrophe, which is this CD right here. This was basically, Steve was still in the band, and then we had a new drummer, Ron Casey, and a new bass player, Ivan Manguia, and they were both amazing musicians as well. Ron just came in and totally picked it up right where Marco left off, and just, I was just blown away. I think he was like 19 at the time or something too, and he was just an amazing drummer, just super fast. Pretty much, you know, it was like there wasn't even a lineup change at all. He just nailed everything so fast, and he was super calm about everything and just picked up stuff, and he, you know, also added in a lot of his own unique playing as well. He was really paying attention to some of the notes that I was giving him about just, you know, cymbal pinches and just changes and more going along with the riffs more, you know, instead of just doing straight blasting over all the songs, which I thought was great because it made the songs just that much more heavy, technical, and musical sounding. So definitely was stoked on Ron as well. And Ivan, you know, he's a crazy bass player, just gnarly tapping everywhere. And he picked it up just as fast. And, you know, I had no issues at all with guys keeping up, with these two guys keeping up. So, yeah, this is Quantum Catastrophe, again, released in 2010 by Metal Blade Records. The song I think I'm going to play now is Beyond Bludgeon, which is basically like our hit song off of that album. You have to kind of bear with me because I'm not, I have this crappy computer that I bought for $30, so none of the songs are going to start out with a 4 count, so I have to kind of just play them off YouTube and jump in. So here we go for Beyond Bludgeoned. And I apologize for the screw-ups. This is the first time I've even touched my guitar in like almost a year. Basically I didn't touch my guitar since after we recorded. Until now, from between when I was done with my guitar tracks until right now, which was like almost a year. So here we go. Hopefully there's not a commercial. We'll be right back. So that was Beyond Bludgeoned. Off of, Quantum Catastrophe. So then that brings us to our last album. The current album, which is Boundless Obscenity. This is a great album. I'm super stoked on it. This was with Travis Morgan on vocals, and Steve had left the band, so this was now me, Travis Morgan, and Ron left the band too. So we got a new drummer, the name of Alex Bent, who played live drums for Testament and Decrepit Birth, and he's also a member of Archaic.